Hey everybody, welcome back to the Hard Park 703 channel. So I've got something really, really cool in store for the Mercedes. It's really late at night. We gotta wake up bright and early. My buddy wanted me out of the shop at 9 a.m. It's not too far, but I don't normally wake up earlier than even 8:45 when I have to work. So yeah, it's funny, like, when you're waking up early to do something that you don't want to do, you can't wake up at all. I probably am at the age where I probably still can't wake up even for something that I do want to do, like modifying the car. But I'm going to give it a go. And so, yeah, we're going to kick off bright and early tomorrow. And we'll pick this up as soon as I get to my buddy's shop. So, see you guys in a little bit. So, just arrived at my buddy Scott's shop. I'll give you a guess at what we're going to be doing today. So, took the day off from work. Took the earliest available appointment that he has. What do we have? I guess it's simple to explain. We got cutouts. So, I'm going to see which, where we want to put it. I'm gonna see where we want to put it, because I don't think there's much room under there. So I've got kind of an idea of where it's gonna go. It's gonna go more towards the back of the car, but we'll get into all that as soon as it gets up on the lift. So what I want to do is I want to take off resonators, the extra mufflers, and then throw the cutouts on. So then that way, when the cutouts are closed, it should still be pretty quiet, almost like factory sounding, I'm hoping. Where it won't bother anybody and nobody would be the wiser. And then when you open them up, it'll definitely give that like kind of AMG sound, you know? About to head into the shop and stuff, and then we'll get this thing on the lift and we'll take it from there. All right, so just about to put it on the lift. We're gonna try to figure out where we wanna put the cutouts exactly, or if we wanna keep the routing of all the piping the same. Maybe we wanna... All right, so just got up on the lift. All right, so we're gonna hack these two off. These are resonators. We're just gonna hack them off right here and then just put in straight pipes right there. Then we're coming back here. These are the secondary mufflers, because you can see like these massive suitcase mufflers right here. These do a really good job at deadening sound. They travel high up in there, so they're like twice the size of this. So we're gonna get rid of these, and then we're probably gonna reshape the piping. And then right now we're trying to figure out what angle we wanna put the cutouts at. So we got some work. We got some work to do. All right, so we got the resonators off already, and we got the straight pipe right there, those two. Now we're moving on to the rear right here. Just gonna see it. Now you can see the routing's pretty much the same, slightly more bend, right? So then that way it flows well, and then that way we still have room for the cutout right here. So we're gonna weld that up, and then now we've got it all marked up where we're gonna do the cuts. So then that way these come out the sides right here, and then that way we'll have plenty of room. So they're gonna dump out to the side. I was thinking they were gonna dump out to the middle, but I didn't want that. I'm happy that we went this route, because I did want them to dump out more towards the side. And so this should sound really good. It should still sound like as if it's coming out the rear of the vehicle. You get what I'm saying? Like, because if I could have bypassed all of this if there was room. I could have bypassed all of this and you could do like technically cutouts over here, but I didn't want the sound coming out from the front of the vehicle. I wanted the sound still coming out from the rear of the vehicle. So that's why I wanted to do it further back here. So yep, everything's looking good. So this is where we're at right now at this point. So first time that this is up on a lift and I just see this. Look at all this from the previous owner. Like, this is not bottoming out, like, on the highway. Because, like, even when you're lowered in sport mode with the active, with the air suspension, it still doesn't go low enough to do this. I know what this looks like to me is the person who doesn't care, and they would pull it over on top of the curb, like, when you park anywhere, you know? And then, so you scrape it going up on the curb, and then you scrape it coming back off, right? Or, and, like, just, that breaks my heart, man. Like, luckily this car sits so low, I didn't even see that until right now, obviously. So this thing's gonna sit lower once I put the suspension module on there. So yeah, you know, little things that like previous people just don't appreciate. I guess the person appreciated the vehicle a little bit, but not as much as me, I guess. So I was inquiring to see if we could do something about like tips, right? I want to do some custom tips. The problem that we have here is the pipe in there, it's oval, it's not round. So it'd be difficult to get tips to come off of it, right? Because I don't care for the tips to be functional, because we're just gonna use the cutouts. But obviously you can see the problem. If you've got a pipe that's like this, and then you're gonna have pipes that are like this, how are you gonna weld? Like, I mean, I guess maybe you could like spot weld them or something. I mean, I don't know the process, but it doesn't seem like it's gonna work, because also the tips are a lot longer, right? So like, I feel like the tips would probably come out to here. So we'd have to cut to here anyways in order to weld the tips on. So I'm thinking if that's the case, like if we're not gonna be able to do that, then I've seen the aftermarket. They've got full stainless steel, the AMG looking tips that fit in here without you having to replace the whole rear bumper, the whole rear balance to do the AMG balance and everything. Because I don't want to put the AMG rear on here because it's not an AMG. But I do want a little bit more like aggressive look back here, just something to stand out a little bit. So if that's the case, then I'm just going to order these up that have the split down the middle, and then that way it'll stand out just slightly. But I'm not going to change out the emblems or anything like that. I mean, it's still going to say SL550. I'm not going to try to like fake it as a full on AMG, you know? So this is where we're putting the cutouts. So they're gonna come out slightly. You can see. Cutouts right there. Oh, it's coming out looking so good. Oof, look at these. These are looking good. Look at that. Oh, I love it. Can't wait to hear what this thing's gonna sound like. So these are the turn downs right here. So then now it's, cause these are gonna be faced this way, right? So here's the motor, and then these are the turn downs. So then it dumps more towards the road. Cause otherwise this would be letting like the gap of the exhaust gases like come out this way. So then this way, at least it makes the flow go down this way. You know what I'm saying? So it's not needed, but it's just an extra touch that I wanted, you know? Just curious to see what these look like on the inside. So it's just straight through. So yeah, definitely a resonator, not a secondary cat. Cause obviously a secondary cat would have like the honeycomb and whatnot. So yeah, this definitely seems like it would baffle a whole lot of sound. So, pretty cool. All right, well, those are off. So check it out. So Joey just finished up this part right here. Look at this, welds look so good. This thing looks OEM, because we didn't even touch this. And look, like, so. See, so we got them facing out this way, so they're horizontal, they're tucked up under the car, so I don't have to worry about it bottoming out. Like when I air this thing out, I thought these were going to be angled down slightly, so this is perfect. It's going to be nice and flat. So see, that's a big opening right there, and then on this side, see, so, and then we got it right here. So I'm just gonna bolt these to it. Joey, so right now you're routing the, what is this?
Like routing the wiring for the key fob.
Okay, for the Bluetooth like module or whatever?
Yeah.
Okay, gotcha. And so where does it get routed to, like in the car? Does it go into like the trunk?
It's gonna go into the trunk.
Okay.
And wired into the battery.
Cool. Joking with Joey right now, I bet you there was some type of crazy critter right there. I would have freaked out. And this is the problem when the car like sits in the garage for so long or whatever, dude. I've got like those black widows and stuff. Thank God it's not here. So right now, yep, just getting it right in through the trunk, the wiring. So, oh, this is all routed. It's awesome. So where did this come through? Okay, cool. So this came through like a piece right there then, huh? Like,
yeah, you just
it's like you pop that out or whatever, and then you got it, yeah. Oh, cool. Okay, so it just came right through there. That's what he was routing. And then this is gonna be, this gets routed to the battery then?
What gets? This gets routed to the battery.
Oh, okay.
And then right, so the module. Plug into these.
Oh, cool, okay. Nice, awesome. So you ran the wiring like in the back?
Yeah. Comes up through, comes over, up and around.
Okay.
And then the hot and negative come off right there and there.
Ah, oh, that is so clean. Oh, that's awesome. All right. Yep. Okay. First startup. So the fuse is blown. So we were able to open the valves, but then when we tried to close them, oh, we were able to close the valves, but then when we tried to open them back up, they just wouldn't open up. So now we were seeing what the problem could be, and it turned out that we found a blown fuse. So
blown fuse again.
Another blown fuse. Turns out the module box itself is, the controller is bad. So I'm gonna have to call them up and have them send me a new one. So what they're gonna do is they're gonna leave the valves closed so I can drive this. And then once I get the new one, we'll swap it out. And then that way I can actively open and close the valves. So until then, can't really do much. What a pain. So I ended up picking up a new remote controller. And so we're about to wire this thing up. Hopefully this one works. It should work just fine. And so now we'll finally be able to open and close the valves. Right now they've been closed for the last couple days. Still, vehicle sounds really, really good. I'll take videos. Once I get home and everything, blah, 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 I'll take videos of it open and closed, obviously, and then like cold starts, blah, blah, blah. So yeah, you guys will get the full picture and everything. Right now I'm just trying to get some content of us wiring this thing up and then playing with the remotes. So Raul was schooling me on this stuff. So it's not difficult to wire up like controllers. All you need to do is wire up the power, obviously. You wire the ground. So you just gotta you gotta crimp on the connector, the end of it. And then it's pretty much it. The hardest part is actually running the cable into the vehicle. And so luckily this was pretty accessible because everything's down there, right? And then we ran all the cabling through there and then into here. So install was a breeze. It literally took, I think, not even 2 minutes. Literally, the controller was bad. So the company was trying to tell me that it was our fault and everything. No, it wasn't. Like, we literally just hooked it all back up the exact same way. It works perfectly. So lesson learned, man. Sometimes you do business with companies that are just shady.
Our vehicle now for a few days. The exhaust note is out of this world. I had no idea what to expect. I really had no idea what to expect. I love my Corvette. I love it to death, right? The tune and the sound, everything is just, it's perfect. And just the growl, the pops, the burbles, everything just, oh, right? Well, now this thing, I might go as far as saying, like, I think I love this exhaust note more than the Corvette. Like, it's both V8s, right? Both, like, growl pretty firm. But this thing, the pops and burbles out of this thing now is, it's nuts, okay? Even like on a different level than the Corvette. I'm gonna film all of it. So what I'm thinking is I'm gonna do a cold start now with the valves open. So you can hear it, and then it'll like quiet down like 15 seconds, right? Like you'll hear a significant difference between super loud or whatever, and then it'll go much quieter. And then I'm gonna go ahead and close the valves so you can hear the big difference there too, and then I'll open them up again. So yeah, it's a big difference. And but here's the thing, even with the valves closed, you can tell there's a V8 under the hood when you walk behind it. Like if you're if you're like 10 feet away, you probably won't even hear anything out of this. But when you get close enough, like probably like 4 to 5 feet away or whatever, you can feel that slight little rumble and you can tell it's a V8, not a V6, not a four cylinder. Like it's hard to explain, but it's not loud, but you can still tell there's something there. And that's great because when the valves are closed, I mean, that's what I wanted, right? Basically stock. And so, even with the valves closed, when you get on it, it gets a little louder, right? When you get on it though, but if you're just cruising, you're not gonna hear anything. And then with the valves open, it's gnarly. But yeah, the pops and burbles out of this thing are just crazy. And I don't even have to try as hard. Like with the Corvette, I really have to get on it to get it to pop and burble, right? Like I have to do some really aggressive downshifts. On this thing, I don't. I'm just cruising and then I'm like stopping at a light or whatever and just like, pow, 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 you know? So, and they're pronounced too. So we're gonna film all that right now. Tomorrow I'm gonna wash the car. I'll take it to like an empty parking lot and I'll rev it with the valves open and then with the valves closed so you can hear the difference. And then we'll cruise around and so you can hear what it sounds like inside the cabin. Cause outside, like when the valves are closed, you're probably aren't gonna really hear anything. But inside the cabin, you still feel the pops and burbles and you can hear them slightly, right? And so with the valves open, you hear it a lot more inside. And you even feel it. You feel the vibration big time coming through the seat, which is awesome. So anyways, all right, I'm going to shut up. And actually, you know what? Let me show you something real quick.
Check this out. Okay.
So instead of having, I got the keys in my pocket. Okay, so I got a key, like not a key fob, but... Right, I've got the one for the Corvette, right, which I've never used because I just always use the visor to turn it on and off, you know. And then same situation for the Mercedes now, because instead of keeping this like with your key fob and everything like that, you know, they created like a 3D printed, I guess, holder or whatever you would call it. Yeah, and so it's cool because it clips onto your visor, and then you can put one of these, the Bluetooth, whatever, you know what I'm saying. And so, yeah, so now I just keep it here. And so I just open it and close it this way. But considering I'm filming for you guys, I'm going to go ahead and, use the one in my pocket. But yeah, I mean, it's pretty cool. It's 3D printed, but it's junk because it came cracked in half. And so I had to glue it and now the glue broke off. So I'm going to try to get like a flexible glue. So then that way, like it holds it, and so then it doesn't finish cracking all the way through. But yeah, so anyways, just wanted to show that real quick. All right, let's turn the car on.
All right, so even from this angle, you can't see the cutouts because like the cutouts are just like right before the muffler. So all you can see right now is the muffler. So from the back and from the bottom, it just looks completely stock. So that's awesome because you can't even tell where the cutouts are. Once I'm done filming this segment or whatever, I'll get underneath it. And then hopefully, obviously I can get the camera down there or whatever, and then we can see the cutouts open and close. So, all right, let me start the car up. Completely like silent, and that I didn't close the valves, so watch. All right, so you can still hear something, right? So now I'm gonna close the valves. You heard that, right? Okay, so now the valves are completely closed, and so now you don't hear anything. Now it just sounds like a regular car. Okay, now valves open. See? So you can even hear the motor. So now it's fully open. And so you can feel it. Like right now I feel it. The pulses, right? So I'm not gonna rev it here because obviously I don't want it to get too loud. But yeah, so that's open, and so now here I'll check it. Look, I'll close it again. See? Alright, so now let's get under the car.
See, it's a big difference, right? Like, especially with the valves open and valves closed. But like, once this thing goes quiet, it's probably, obviously, since it's turbocharged, that's why it goes quiet, right? I don't know if you would say like a supercharged car doesn't go as quiet as a turbocharged, but granted, the Corvette is much more modified than the Mercedes right now. I mean, it probably always will be. But when I close the valves on the Mercedes, it's significantly louder. And not even just that. That's not the point. When the Corvette warms up, it's still significantly louder. So this thing, before I even closed the valves, it was super quiet. Like as soon as this thing warmed up, it just went quiet. So yeah, I'm thinking it's like the whole system, the whole way it's designed and stuff. But yeah, anyways, let me get under the car.
All right, so let's take a look. Let's see if we can see it. See them? Man, they are tucked in there. Wow, they're tucked in. Okay, different angle. The camera, so now it's closer to the floor. You guys get what I mean? Like with the iPhone, obviously, it's like, I just flipped it around. Okay, so you can see them right there. I don't know if you guys can hear me, I hope so. But yeah, so there's one right there. And then the other one's right over there. I guess I'm gonna focus on this one. Let's see. Ah, it's so hot, my face is in there. Okay. Move out of the way. Okay. Can I see anything? I can't even see. Dude, those things are so... Okay, you can see that it dumps out. It dumps out towards the tire, like out to the side of the vehicle. Well, obviously you guys can see that because I already filmed that, so duh. Okay, so check this out. So right now they're closed, right? So since they're closed, the vapors are coming out of here, right, obviously? So now, I'm gonna open them. See? And so now they're coming out of there, and they're not coming out of here. So now, here, there's nothing. Now it's further down here. So, that's as close as I can get. I can't get further under the car. It's too low right now. So, it's dripping. I guess it's dripping condensation out, so obviously they're open. And so now, closed. Fully closed, nothing there, and now everything's coming out back here. That's awesome.
Good morning. So I was just about to pull the car out to wash it. Sorry, it's early. No, it's not. It's not really early. It's 11 a.m., but that's early for me. So anyways, I've got the valves closed, so I'm going to do a cold start with the valves closed just so you guys can hear what it's like at its loudest, I guess, with the valves closed. You'll see... You'll see it's significantly different than like yesterday with the... start with the valves closed. I replayed the segment from yesterday with the valves open, and I didn't really hear much of a difference. So the cold start sounds like it's the exact same. I'm pretty sure I ended it with us closing the valves. And so whatever setting you left it on, that's how that's the setting that the vehicle is going to start on. So I was pretty sure the valves were closed. But anyways, I'm pretty sure again that the valves are closed right now. It's been like, I don't know, like probably over 2 hours and stuff since I've washed the car and everything. So I'm going to put it in the back and I'm going to start it up again to see if it sounds the exact same or if it's even quieter. So yeah, point is I'm trying to prove that it's not that loud when you start it up with the valves closed, but this segment is making me out to be a liar. So I'm trying to prove it.
All right. So in theory, the valves should be closed and I'm going to start it up. And I really hope I'm pretty accurate with that statement. So, all right, let's do this.
So yeah, it's quiet now that like the whole system has warmed up, but look, if I hit close, they're already closed. So like now that it's warmed up, you don't hear anything. Like right now, remember that little rumble that I was telling you about, that like you can tell there's something under the hood? Like that's it. That little rumble right there, that's it. That's all you get, like that gives a hint that there's something like under the hood per se, right? So like you have to walk about this distance, but like here you really wouldn't be able to tell. Here it just sounds stock. So all right, so that's how quiet it is now that it's warmed up. So I guess the cold start, no matter what, the cold start just, you know, it just seems like it's just as loud as with the valves open. And it's not like there's a feature that the valves are open and then they close themselves, because I would have heard the motor and I didn't hear that the 2 times I already tried this out. So here, let's open it up. So so that's open right there, right? So I'm gonna push it. See, so you heard the motors, and now you definitely can hear that difference, right? You hear like the pulses now, and you can feel it. You can feel it in your chest. Yeah. So, all right. Well, I guess I tried to prove a point, and I was inaccurate. So now you all know. So
closing the valves now.
See, just goes whisper crap. But yeah, I guess ultimately I'm full of crap. So, sorry. Okay. So let's take it out for a spin real quick. I'm gonna start it up with the valves closed, and then we'll drive it around with the valves closed, and then I'll open them up. And then that way we'll see if we can pick up something here in the cabin, because I'm telling you, you can hear it very pronounced here. So I hope it comes out in the video. But all right, let's. All right, so that's whisper quiet. That's with the windows up and everything. I'm debating if I'm gonna keep filming, like if I take the top down, put the windows down, it might pick up the exhaust sound, but I feel like it's gonna pick up way too much wind. So we'll see. Good. Okay. Oh, and like the other thing that I didn't mention is whether you're in eco mode or in sport mode, with regards to the transmission, it sounds pretty much the same. So, I mean, I could switch it. In sport mode, it'll drop it a gear. But for the most part, I mean, it's going to sound the same. So at least that factors out of the equation. But yeah, right now, I mean, the valves are closed and you don't hear anything right now. I'm going to pull out and like pull out to the road, you know, give it a go. I'm just waiting for this car to go. I guess I'll wait a little bit. Considering I'm gonna need to accelerate, I'm gonna catch up to that car pretty quickly, right? Okay, cool. Here we go. All right, so this is still valves closed. So that was with the valves closed. See, so you can hear, once you break 3,000 RPMs, you can definitely hear it. And now it's decelerating about 2,000 RPMs and it rumbles. I don't know if you guys can pick it up. I'll turn it around again. I'm just gonna hit these speed bumps real quick and I'll turn it around. All right, so now I'm going in the opposite direction. I just gotta go over the speed bump and then I can punch it. So we'll see. We'll see if it picks it up even better this time around. That's with the valves closed. Yeah, that's pretty crazy, right? Yeah, so now let's see if I decelerate. Does we hear a rumble? Because I can hear it very faintly. It's like burbling. So that was with valves closed. So now let's do the valves open. All right. So let me open the valves. Okay. So now the valves are open. Okay. Let's give it a go. Are these people crossing the street right now? Please don't tell me they're crossing the street. Okay, good. See, I'm barely accelerating. I'm at 2,200, and now I'm at 1,900. And you can hear that. That's a big difference between the valves closed and valves open. So there's a car in front of me right now. I have to wait. We're good. All right, so now valves are open. Especially with the valves open. So I'll make a U-turn like right. There's a car coming. But all right, I'll make a U-turn right here and we'll go back. All right, so going over the same speed bump and then let's punch it. Oh my God, this thing is so fast. Oh. That's awesome. This thing breaks traction. All I've done is the cutouts. I haven't even done anything else performance-wise. I haven't done a tune or anything. And this thing breaks traction. So, this thing is... I love this thing. See, the exhaust is a big difference between valves closed and then the valves open. Like, this thing definitely rumbles big time. So, pretty cool. And you know what? Now that I'm, like, playing around with all the buttons in here, I just realized we're in eco mode. That wasn't even sport mode. So, it would have definitely broken traction a lot easier had I put it in like the sport transmission setting. So yeah, I mean, it's not gonna make a difference though in sound, so that's why I just left it in eco mode. But you guys definitely get a clear picture of the difference. So let's take it to an empty parking lot now and let's rev it up. So like small little quick pulls too, by the way. Like if I'm on the highway and I'm gunning it for a lot longer, the pops and burbles will be much more pronounced. So this was just quick little spools, but all right, let's get to the empty parking lot. I gotta pee real quick first, so I'm stopping by the house. All right, and we're off. So now it's a warmed up start with the valves open. Yeah, much more pronounced. Okay, we're off. While I'm working my way out of the neighborhood here, let's see if there's any difference in, like right now I'm in eco. So accelerating, hear the rumble right now, and then you hear the terrible spooling. If I put it in sport mode, I don't think there's gonna be much of a difference, so I'm approaching speed bump. Let's put it in sport mode. Okay, so now it's in sport mode, so now it drops at one gear. Obviously it picks up a lot faster, and so yeah, since the RPMs are going up higher, faster, then it sounds louder. So, but man, the turbo spool sounds so good. I forgot how much I miss turbocharged vehicles. I was in my head, like, for the longest time being like, oh, supercharger's superior, blah, blah, blah. And, I mean, I don't think so. Have that eco like button mode on, so it just turns off the vehicle. All right, now we can go. It's all uphill, so I'm just gonna waste so much gas right now filming. Tell me you heard that. I know the bladder is going off right now because it's hugging me, but tell me you heard that. That sounded so good. All right, let's try it again. That sounds so good. That sounds so good. I hope it came out. I hope it came out. Like, now I know. All right, sport mode, valves open. That's going to give me the best pops and burbles now. So I'm learning that as I'm filming. So we're going right here. I just got to wait for this red light. It takes forever. It's going to go through a whole cycle. So that's it. Those bladders go on. They go off every single, like, slight turn. Just tss. But it's an awesome feature, though. All right, so I'm in the parking lot. I guess I'll just, I don't want to bother. Who cares? I need to stop caring about the world so much. But anyways, I'll face it towards the business. So, if I face it towards the business, technically, I shouldn't be bothering anybody. Okay, turn it around. Give it a go. I mean, it's in sport mode right now, the transmission, so I mean, I'll leave it in that mode for now. We'll do valves open, I guess, since the valves are open right now, and then I'll just close them and then you'll hear the difference. Okay, so the valves are open right now. I haven't changed any settings or anything like that. Transmission's in sport, whatever, blah, blah, blah. All right, let me just rev it a couple times.
Okay, so haven't heard what it sounds like yet. It's not as loud as like when I'm, it's weird. Like when it's parked, like even me inside the vehicle, it just, it doesn't sound loud at all. So it's much louder when I'm actually under load and driving it. So I'm curious why that is. I mean, it goes up. It goes up to like 5,000 RPMs, just like the Vette, right? Like it doesn't go to red line. And so I assume that's because of the automatic transmission. But there's people like just, they came to see what I was filming. It's so awkward. Like this is the, every time I come here with the Corvette, people circle in and then want to see like what I'm doing. And then now with the Mercedes, just weird. It's a fully empty parking lot. Like just weirdos. But anyways, I'm gonna close the valves right now. You'll hear me close the valves. You'll hear the motors, and then I'll rev it again, and then we'll see what it sounds like. But it's so weird. It just doesn't sound loud revving it while it's parked. It doesn't do it justice at all. Like it was significantly, like it sounded louder with my windows up when I was punching it on the road than it did right here. That's weird. All right, so I'm gonna close the valves and then I'm gonna rev it again. Almost the exact same right now with the valves closed. Like at least from inside the cabin, it sounded like same decibel level and everything. Weird. But anyways, all right, cool. So now you guys have an idea of what it sounds like when it's parked. And then, I mean, I don't think it's gonna rain. It's super cloudy, but they didn't call for any rain. So I wanna take the top down. Like maybe we'll film it again with the top down. Yeah, maybe we can get some good pops. So I'll take the top down now. Fingers crossed it doesn't rain like today, because that's gonna break my heart. But all right, I'll take the top down right now, and then I'll film with the valves open, heading back home, and we'll see if we can get some even more pops, because obviously that was pretty gnarly, the pops while I was driving on my way here. Okay, let's get going. Which one's the button for the top down? I think it's this big silver one. So I think it'll do the windows too on its own. I'll just give it a try. Hold it. I'm not forgetting anything, am I? All right. Okay, cool. All right. Yeah. All right, we're good. Okay. Maybe I'll even put up the windscreen thing. Maybe that'll help with the in-cabin noise or something. I don't know. I just put the windows down. I don't know. That doesn't make sense. But anyways, okay, sport mode is on. Let's open the valves. Okay, they're open. All right. Let's go. They designed it that way, so you can't speed in this parking lot. So just, it's annoying. Okay, getting out to the light. Okay. Let's go. Oh, got a green light. Got a green light. Gotta go. We gotta go for it. We gotta go for it. Okay. Turning. Thank you.
yeah, that wind noise is too much, so... All right, just be happy with the clips that we got with the windows up and the top up and everything, because I don't think it's going to come out here. I mean, we'll go through this light. Okay. It sounds so good, but I know that wind noise is really interfering right now with the sound quality. I should have put one of those, like, mics or whatever. I even have it. I have the mic with a little fuzzy thing or whatever like that. It's just... I'm so lazy to use it. I'm sorry. Just deal with the fact that it is what it is. Say pop. So back home. I'll tell you what. I'll cruise around a little bit with the top down. Oh, that turbo spool. The turbo spool. I'm going to cruise around with the top down a little bit. And then when I put it back up, like in a few hours, I'll film again. So then that way the vehicle will be nice and warm for the whole day and everything. And then we'll pick it up just one more time, because I definitely want to get better clips of it popping and crackling and everything like that. I mean, we got glimpses of it just previously, but obviously I think I can do it again. So anyways, I'll upload that in a sec. So it turns out I'm on call this weekend. So I've been rushing back home every single time there's... quote unquote, an emergency call, and not once has it been, just, some people suck. Anyways, all right, so point is, I was editing some of the footage that I've been shooting today, and I noticed that on some of the best pulls that I did, I guess the phone mount right here, where I've got the phone, it was a little... what do you call it? It was a little loose, waving to a neighbor. And so, for that matter, you can hear the clatter or clanking, whatever you want to call it. And so it didn't come out good. And so that bothers me. So we're gonna do it again. We're gonna do it with the valves open. And so yeah. So I'm gonna get out of the neighborhood real quick, and then I'm gonna open up the valves, and we'll give it a go again. And I made sure that things are a lot more secure this time around. I cranked down on the clamps here for the phone. So, all right, let's get to it. Another little side note, I'm definitely gonna have to change out the brake pads. Brake pads have tons of life left, but man, like the wheels are completely like caked over. So they're like black right now. It's horrible. Like the whole car's clean and then the wheels are just so, so dirty. So I'm going to change out the brake pads for a different company. You know, there's a whole bunch of companies that will still offer, like, a really aggressive bite. I'm going through the light. Bye-bye. Dude, this thing accelerates on a dime. But, yeah, anyways, back to the brakes. So, for that matter... I'll choose some or look for some that don't produce as much brake dust, because this, it sucks, man. Like, I'm gonna get to the car shows this upcoming season, and all of a sudden, like, wipe down the, it's not a big deal wiping down the wheels and everything, but still, I mean, I just don't want to go through that hassle. Another fun little tidbit. Can you guys hear that? That's awesome. That's not what I'm talking about. All right, so point being, just me filming and doing a couple pulls, this thing is so much worse on gas than the Corvette. Now, granted, the Corvette is tuned, this one is not, so even the Rentec shelf tune, like, I would hope it dials things in nicely, so then that way I get the performance bump, but then also, like, you know, it... when I'm not using it, it'll give me better gas mileage, because otherwise I'm gonna have to take this to more automotive and see what they can do and stuff, because it's just chugging away gas. And so, yeah, like this is how I remember this. This is what happened with the Corvette. I remember I started modifying it, and then I was just like, oh, it must be, it is what it is, right? Like, you're modifying a big V8, don't worry about gas, bro. All this blah blah, and then once I got it tuned, I still got all the crazy extra power and even better gas mileage. So I assume it would be the same situation with this setup. It's burbling.
Let's see if it does it.
I'm about to hop on the highway, so I'll... I'm gonna hop on the highway and then I'm gonna punch it a couple times and stuff, and then like when I'm coming up to a light, I'm sure it'll pop and stuff. So, but anyways, yeah. So those are my little thoughts that I wanted to throw in here. But yeah, so little by little, start doing more and more stuff. I have so much stuff at home, by the way. Like I wanted to finish the exhaust video before I even uploaded the next video. I have so many things already in my room, like piled up, that are gonna go on this car. So yeah, this it's gonna be awesome.
Do I have the straightaway? I do. I do. I do.
Oh my god! Well, all right, I'm way over the speed limit. Slowing down. Oh my god! So many cars. And there's a cop. There's a cop. Three cars ahead. I wasn't doing anything bad. Oh, that's awesome. Popping is so worth it, but I don't want to go to jail. So. Yep. Alright, I'm going to build some distance. I'm going to have to get off the highway. Man, I wanted to do a punch and then. Do a punch. I wanted to punch it and then, you know, come up slowly to the red light so you could hear it, but. I had it completely stopped. I just wanted to mash it in sport mode.
We could try it here.
All right. A couple cars coming. All right, let's go. This thing is insane. This thing is a bullet. Wow. This thing is nuts. Wow. Like, if I think the fact that this pushes me back in the seat more is probably because it has just slightly more traction than the Corvette, because I went too overpowering with the Corvette and I didn't, you know, I don't have drag radials on it and stuff like that, and it's not prepped, you know? So that's why, like, it gives me that rush. The Corvette, I gotta be going in order for me to get that traction. So I can't do it from a light. And there's a cop right in front of me. I wouldn't be surprised if that's the exact same cop that was on the highway. I'm almost certain that's probably the same cop that was in front of me when I turned off. So I guess we can't.
Right here. Cop's gone now.
Thank you.
no red light, so there's no decelerating, so I'm just still up in the gears. Finally. All right, good. I got them to come out on video. That's pretty much it. I think I figured out the sweet spot. So like if I blip it right above 2000 RPMs and then let it drop, it'll do it. So I'm gonna test that out right now. It's kind of like how I had to figure out the sweet spot on the Corvette. I guess it's the same thing for this. So good.
All right, so just got home. Finally, the quest for the perfect exhaust crackle, burble, pop, whatever is finally completed. Sounds kind of lame, but I was driving around all day trying to get it to be pronounced in the video, right? Because the last thing I would have wanted to do is hype it up and then all of a sudden like you really just couldn't hear a difference. So anyways, drove around all day. This thing is almost at a half a tank of gas. It was full, by the way. Like, that's how badly this thing needs to be tuned then, because, just seeing the needle just go down, I'm just like, this sucks. But, yeah, it's so worth it. This thing sounds so, so gnarly. Anyways, all right, so I'm going to upload, I'm going to stitch everything together, edit it and stuff, take out all the unnecessary parts because I talk way too much. And then, yeah, so anyways, if you like that video, go ahead and click that like button, hit subscribe. So this was the exhaust work that I got done, right? I've got a bunch. I've got other performance modifications. I've also got cosmetics, so like aesthetically pleasing stuff. So I'm gonna start doing all that. As soon as I upload all this stuff or whatever, I'm gonna throw those up on YouTube as well. So yeah, we'll take it from there. I mean, this thing, I want it ready by, I think, like, April. Or March, I guess. Oh, my gosh. We're in March. Yeah, so April, all the car events are going to start up. So, anyways, trying to get this thing ready for the car season. I'm still going to be taking the Corvette out. It's just, I'll probably alternate. But anyways, all right, I'm going to shut up. So, yeah, go ahead and click that like button, hit subscribe, and I'll see you guys real soon. All right, bye.